So this short story is the product of a assignment where we experimented with how setting could move a plot forward, and then also revision and workshopping with my fellow campmates. A hopeful bench. You sit on a bench in a small grove of trees, three to be exact. They stand as if in ritual. Between their trunks, a vista consists of a wide open field climbing a hill until it meets a forest under a cloudless sky. The air is filled with whistles and chirps and buzzes of birds and bugs, but then the click-clack of train tracks abolishes the serenity. The train thunders before the field and bellows its steamy, high-pitched whistle. Its cargo-carrying cars come from the rail yard a multitude of miles behind, just outside a great gray city. Here, no matter how clear the day, the sky always seems to be gray. It's disgusting how people here seem to ignore life, but they all look up at the small opening in the sky between the skyscrapers and feel as caged birds do. It truly is pitiful. However, some people enjoy the hustle and bustle of the city, and more power to them. They race around like telephone wires, the ones that go to the rail yard and follow the train to the docks, where the salty sea smell and the noise of machinery dominate the senses. The feeling it gives is not necessarily energizing, but it does carry a great sense of energy. The dock workers drown in the downness of their luck, or they rejoice in the camaraderie of their fellow workers. Either way, a great many heart-moving stories can be found in their daily lives. Just as the tales are found in the faraway shores where the cargo from the trains is taken by great ships, whose crews have similar tales to those of the dock workers. In those distant lands, the people speak in tongues and dress funny and eat strange foods, and it all tastes of delicious variety. At night, the cities are lit up with singing and dancing that is foreign to the cities across the ocean. The splendor of the gleaming cities is the rainbow that radiates from a pot of gold. And here you are, wishing someone would take you there.